I'm trying to learn game dev, but there's a problem. I have a bad habit of not finishing things, and I've had this problem for a while, even well before I started making videos on YouTube. If we take a quick look back in time, I've written scripts and shot lists for short films that I've never seen the light of day. I have video games that I love sitting at about 70 to 80% complete, and I have the Duolingo owl, distraught that the only time I've opened the app in the past couple months was by accident. But I want this trend to stop. I've done some introspection, and I think I identified three things that have been holding me back. So the question now is, what do I do with this newfound knowledge? I needed to give myself a new project, something that will directly counter what's been keeping me from finishing other projects. It needs to be big enough to force me to stretch myself, yet still small enough to give me a realistic chance at completing it. So I got to work on the details. What would this look like? How long would it take? Most importantly, how is this going to help me with the bigger projects I have in mind as well, like making a 3D game? After some thought, I started to get the feeling that this was going to seem a lot easier on paper than it's going to be in practice. And I was right. But did it work for me though? Well, yeah, I guess it did. Let's try and figure out why. First, we need to talk about the project. I'm trying to learn game dev, and so I also want to learn 3D art to help with that. So, I'm modeling a Christmas scene in Blender, one model at a time, every day from now until Christmas. Maybe it'll look great, or maybe it'll be a disaster, but only one way to find out. Yep, I knew if I wanted to make a 3D game, I would need to learn how to make 3D models. But since I only had the most surface level knowledge of Blender, I thought this would be a good way to increase my skill in that area. But we can't just forget about the issue that I have with finishing projects, so how can I increase my chances of finishing this project as much as possible once I start it? Well, I've come to realize that there are three main issues that I experience that all contribute to me not finishing many of the projects that I start. Feature creep, shiny new thing syndrome, and the fear of finishing. I'll be talking about this in the context of game development, but I think it's important to note that these obstacles aren't limited to game developers. I think that anyone working in a creative sphere has a high likelihood of experiencing at least one of these to some degree. I just happen to struggle with all three. So how did I attempt to counter them? Feature creep is sneaky, because sometimes I don't even realize that it's happening until it's too late. If I think of a game that I want to make and I write it down, it's easy for me to come back later with a small idea to add to it. And then another. And then another. Until eventually, I'd forget that the original idea for the game was supposed to be really simple. But by then, it's gotten to the point that I would need a whole AAA studio to ever finish it. In game development, this can mean adding too many features, enemies, towns, abilities, or items like I wanted to do in this video here. Or in something like script writing, it can mean writing new subplots, backstories, and characters that take away from the original story it was meant to be. This doesn't mean that everything I want to add to my original idea is a bad idea, but it does mean that I have to be more strict about what I add so I can be sure it's not straying from the original vision. So, how did I attempt to counter this? Well, my idea at its core was very clear. I will create one 3D model in Blender every day for 25 days. No more, no less. If I thought of another model that isn't in my original 25, well, it didn't make the cut. I was very strict on this because 26 days of Blender just didn't have the same ring to it. Feature creep is something that can work its way into a project without me knowing about it. But in this case, by numbering all of the models, it would have been very obvious if I started to add on to the original idea. In the end, I was impressed with how well this worked, especially considering how simple the solution was. Of course, I won't be able to limit all my projects as easily as I did this one, but the idea here is to get me used to working with these limitations, because the more I get used to it, the goal is that I'll be able to notice feature creep more easily in the future. The note I'm making for myself here is to clearly define limitations. It makes for a much more cohesive end result. The next issue I struggle with is shiny new thing syndrome. I really like working on new projects, and if I'm working on one project for too long, I tend to get tired of it. Sometimes it's not even that, though. I might not even be tired of a project, but the idea of starting something new is just so enticing. I can start to convince myself, yeah, I can work on two projects at once. I'm definitely not going to neglect the old one. And that's the last time I ever opened that old project again. The worst part is that that project I just started will likely be abandoned as well. And the cycle continues. So, what did I do about this? Well, I drew up a plan. Every day was going to have a new model assigned to it. Collectively, it's all one project, but each day felt completely new. For any given day, I wasn't going to continue where I left off on a model because that day was done, no matter how it looked. Doing it this way helped to keep things fresh and kind of felt like 25 mini projects instead of one larger project that lasted over 3 weeks. I think breaking up projects in this way could really help me going forward because a large part of the issue is about perspective for me. I made a checklist with 25 models that I was going to make, and each time I completed one, I checked it off the list. Each time I did this, it felt like I was moving on to a new project, even if they're all related. Because of that, I never felt the need to quit and move on to something else, because I already was moving on to something else, each and every day. The note I'm making for myself is to break big projects up into smaller sub-projects. Check those small projects off for a dopamine rush, then move on to the next mini project on the list. This last issue I face might sound weird at first, but I think I have a fear of finishing projects. But isn't that the goal when starting any project? Why start a project in the first place if you don't intend on finishing it? Good question, and I guess the answer is that I do intend on finishing any project that I start, but I tend to think that finishing a project has an implication that this was the original vision that I had for this project from the beginning. I know that in reality, it's rarely the case that a project turns out exactly how its creator imagined it would, but still. Sometimes I can't help but tweak it and tweak it endlessly until it does, which never happens. I hate releasing a project if I feel like the vision for it was so much better than the final product. But in many cases, of course it was. When I imagine how I want a project to look, I'm not held back by my lack of knowledge, skills, or time. I'm able to imagine a final product that breaks every physical barrier that holds me back. But when I work on the project, those barriers are very, very real. You know how I can start to chip away at those barriers, though? Finish projects, get feedback, learn from them, and repeat. If I'm not calling projects finished when they're done and moving on to the next one, I'm not able to fully learn from them and apply that knowledge. Learning is not always this neat process of loving everything you make. To truly learn, you need to mess up, try something else, and mess up again. When you're learning, the end product isn't the most important thing. It's, did you learn something? If you did, great, apply it to the next project. By doing this 25-day challenge, I did two things that really helped me with this. The first is that I gave myself hard deadlines. Every day from December 1st through December 25th, I needed to have a model and a short finished and released. It didn't matter how much I wanted to keep tweaking it or if I thought it was done or not. By the end of the day, the short was going to be posted because I said it was going to be. Which brings me to the second thing that helped me with this. If I tell someone I'm going to do something, I absolutely hate the feeling of not delivering, which is why I try to do everything I can to make sure I do what I said I would do. That alone is usually enough to give me a big boost in determination, which is why I started off each video how I did. So, I'm modeling a Christmas scene in Blender, one model at a time, every day from now until Christmas. Each and every video starts with this, including the very first one. Whoever watches any of the videos now has an expectation that I'm going to deliver on that promise. This was very intentional and a little scary, but it worked. The note I'm making for myself on the fear of finishing is to make a deadline and tell people about it. Have them hold you accountable so you don't get stuck tweaking endlessly. Done is better than perfect. Being so focused on directly countering what's been holding me back helped so much for this project, but I'd be lying if I said there wasn't another thing that helped me a lot too. Seeing the projects that people in our community Discord have been making has been extremely encouraging as well. If you're not in a community where you can be encouraged, get feedback, and be inspired, you're doing yourself a huge disservice. If you're looking for one centered around game development that does exactly that, feel free to join our community. I'll have the Discord link in the description. I'll also have a link to the 25 Days of Blender playlist if you'd like to check out the finished project I talked about in this video. I might have been talking about my own struggles, but I know that I'm not the only person who this applies to. Whether that person is you or not, keep making things and keep learning. I'll see you in the next video.